Hello friends, once again welcome to you all in my YouTube channel. Okay, so here we discuss the brachial plexus. Okay, so brachial means the brachium. Okay, so what is the mean of brachium? The brachium, it is a part of the upper limb. The what is the mean of upper limb? Okay, so your via that whatever you can hold it, okay, that is nothing but the upper limb. Okay, so that upper limb has the three parts, has the three region, that is the brachium, antebrachium and the hands. Okay, that a brachium region from the shoulder joint to the elbow joint, that area which is present, that is termed as the brachium. Okay, so the brachial plexus means the plexus mean you can say that the group of nerve. Okay, in Hindi you can say that the jal. Okay, so the network of, or you can say the network of nerves, or you can say that a group of nerves, that is termed as the plexus. And the brachial means that that a nerve which is arised, that ultimately that is a finished in the brachium region. Okay, so that is termed as the brachial plexus. The group of nerve arise in the brachium region, that is termed as the brachial plexus. That plexus is arise from the spinal cord. Okay, so here you see that the scaly muscles, and that via that scaly muscles, you know that our body is in a plane manner via that vertebral column. Okay, and you know very well that the vertebral column has a 26 vertebrae and the 33 vertebra. Okay, and the 26 vertebrae, there is 7 cervical, 12 thoracic and the 5 lumbar and the 1 sacral and the 1 coccygeal. Okay, these are 26 vertebrae, and via these vertebrae that you know that the between that the neural canal is there, and that via this neural canal the spinal cord run in that neural canal, that is called as a spinal column. In that spinal column, the whole neural canal of the whole vertebra, that term as the spinal column, in that spinal column, that spinal cord runs, and via that spinal cord, you know that the dorsal and ventral rami are produced. Okay, if in the spinal cord video, we discussed that what is the ventral rami and the what is the dorsal rami. So for that here point of view, you understand first thing, that is the spinal cord give the nerve. Okay, that is nothing but the that nerve is nothing but the mixed nerve. Okay, and that nerve is emerges out via that the intervertebra foramen, you can say the intervertebra. Okay, so inter between the vertebra there is some space are there, and via that space that nerve is leave out, and the nerve is leave out. Okay, that nerve after the leaving, that give the three branches, that is nothing but the dorsal and the dorsal rami, ventral rami and the ramus communicans. The ramen communicans is responsible for the ANS, that is nothing but the autonomic nervous system. Okay, and that dorsal rami is nothing but the dorsal means the upper part. That a ventral rami means it goes through the ventral, that is nothing but the deep part of the things, deep part of the upper limb, deep part of the brachium. Okay, so that is the point. Okay, so brachium, antebrachium. Okay, so that is nothing but the brachial plexus. The group of nerve arise from the spinal cord, spinal nerve. That is nothing but the formation, that nerve is nothing but the ventral rami, and that ventral rami together they form the nerve and a group of nerve. That nerve is termed as the plexus, and that supply to the brachium. Okay, so as the yellow color portion, you know that is nothing but the nerve, and that nerve is supplied to the brachium region, that is termed as the brachium, and that group of nerve, that is termed as the many nerve arise in the same manner, in the same align, in the same condition, that is termed as the plexus, that is a group of nerve. Here it is in short manner, I brachial plexus I want to explain to you. Okay, the C5, C6, C7, C8 and T1, these are the vertebra. Okay, how it is the vertebra? C8 vertebra you never heard, okay? C8 vertebra means the portion present between the C7 and the T1, that nerve is arise from that one nerve is arise, that is termed as the C8. That nothing but the if I say that the C5, that nothing but the in that C5 vertebra, that is the fifth cervical vertebra, the part of the spinal column, that is the part of the spinal cord, that is the spinal cord, the segment of the spinal cord present inside that that is the fifth cervical vertebra, that is called as the spinal segment. And via that spinal segment, the C5 nerves, or you can say the ventral rami of the C5 is emerges out. Okay, so that is all. This is the all the roots, that is nothing but the ventral rami, the ventral rami of the spinal column, spinal cord. Okay, so spinal cord, you can say that the spinal nerve, because the spinal nerve emerges into three branches. Okay, so that is nothing but the ventral rami, that is termed as the root. Okay, that is the C5 ka root, C6 ka root, C7 ka root, C8 ka root and the T1 ka root. The root continue with the trunk. Okay, that is nothing but the trunk. How the trunk? The C5 and the C6, both that is the root of the C5 and the C6, that is 5th and the 6th cervical vertebra, they joint and they form the upper trunk. And the C7 not joined with any other vertebra of any other vertebra, okay, cervical vertebra, and it alone they form the middle trunk. Continue, okay. And the C8 and the T1, that is the C8, that is the between the C7 and the T1, one nerve is arised, okay, that is termed as the C8. That C8 and the T1, that is the C8, eighth cervical vertebra and the first thoracic vertebra, both joined, they form the lower trunk, okay. And each trunk, okay, each trunk further divide into the two branches, the term as the dorsal and the ventral. Okay, the division, the dorsal division and the ventral division. The dorsal division of the upper, middle and the lower trunk, both together, that is the dorsal of this and the dorsal of this, these all three whole in form that a posterior cord. Okay, and that the ventral rami of the upper trunk and the middle trunk form the lateral cord, and itself the ventral division of the upper and the middle trunk, they form the lateral cord, and the ventral division of the lower trunk not unite with any other ventral division, they alone form the middle cord. And itself that cord is giving their different branches, that is nothing but the lateral cord give the branches, the lateral root of the median nerve and the musculocutaneous nerve. Okay, these are the musculocutaneous nerve which supply to the biceps brachii muscles, and the lateral root of the median nerve and the median root of the median nerve, which is a branch of the medial cord, they both together form the median nerve, which supply to the part of the muscles, which innervates to the muscles of the forearm. Okay, so that is the median root of the median nerve and the lateral root of the median nerve, that together they form the median nerve. And the one more branch is arise from the medial cord, that is termed as the ulnar nerve. Okay, ulnar nerve means medially whatever the control, that is the innervation, whatever the nerve supply is taking place via the ulnar nerve. And the posterior cord also showing the two branches, that is nothing but the radial nerve and the axillary nerve. Axillary nerve innervates to the deltoid muscle, and the radial nerve, you know that in the lateral lead segment of the forearm, that is the lateral part of the forearm region, it supply via the radial nerve. Okay, so at the end of this video, I want to tell that the each cord give the two branches, the lateral cord give the lateral root of the median nerve and the musculocutaneous nerve, the middle cord median nerve, medial cord give the two branches, the medial root of the median nerve and the ulnar nerve, and the posterior cord give the radial nerve and the axillary nerve. The innervation and where it is innervates, all things are discussed. Okay, so that is all about the today's lectures. Okay, thanks for watching the video. Have a nice day.